question asked by Vineet is, why can't the brain be in the present? Because Vineet, the present is not. You see, your mind makes sense of the world around, right? Your mind continuously makes sense of this world around. But can your mind make sense of this moment? This moment is outside the domain of your mind. Mind never lives in this moment. How do you know that your mind is functional? How do you know that you have a functional brain? How do you know? Through your thoughts, right? Through your thoughts. That is what the mind is always doing. Thinking. Or memories, or hopes, which are all nothing but thoughts. The mind lives in these thoughts, these images, right? All of that is past. The mind exists in time, in past or in future. The very existence of mind is time. And this moment is not time. You go into your mind, observe it. Whatsoever it does, it has to do with time. Whatsoever it does is surely related to time. Let me give you an example. You can never think of something which is not there in your past, right? The mind falls flat, falls absolutely dead when it is asked to go beyond time. Try thinking of something which is beyond your past, right? Can you do that? Can you think of anything that is not there in your past? The mind falls dead the moment time is taken away from it. Another example. Try imagining anything that is not in space. Try imagining anything that is not in space. Try. Give me a single example. Imagine it. Imagine it. When I say imagine, there must be an image with it. And surely happiness has an image in your mind. How do you know somebody is happy? So there is an image, right? Expression. Expression on the? And the face is in? So happiness is in space. Because all images are in time and space. Do you see this? The mind becomes dysfunctional the moment time and space are taken away from it. Because the mind is nothing but that. Are you getting it now? Why the mind can't be in the present? Because the very substance of mind is the past. All the mind thinks, all that it can think comes from the past. It knows no way, nothing else except its own data and programming. And all of that is there in the past.
By saying that the mind can't think of anything as other than that works in time and space, that means time and space are included in mind, but that doesn't mean that mind is only time and space.
Then if mind is not time and space, if we say that there are two sets A and B, and if we want to say that A is anything other than B, if there are two sets A and B, and if we want to say that A is anything other than B, then A must have at least one element which is not in. Are you getting it? If all of B is in A, listen to this carefully. If all of B is in A, statement 1, and additionally, A has nothing that is not in B, then that means that A is identical with B. A and B are the same, right? Is there anything in mind which is beyond time and space, going back to the same examples? Your question, Tajveer, was that I understand that time and space are in mind, but mind can be something beyond that as well. Time and space plus plus. What is that plus plus? Find it out. Is there anything there which is not in time and space? I said, imagine anything which is not in space and think of anything which is not in time. Can you do that? Can your mind do that? Every single bit of the mind, every single thought is that. So mind, in that sense, is time and space. It does not even contain time and space. The mind is time and space. A and B are identical. A and B are identical.